Well, hello folks. We've got Snapshot 21w44a on our hands, and it has some nifty technical improvements. If you want to know about the equally nifty gameplay improvements, check out my gameplay updates video right here. In this one, we're going to go through new server options, new block tags, and the custom world news. My name is slicedlime, let's get into it with that new server option. It's a new server.properties entry called hide online players with the default value false. If it is set to true, the server will not include any players in the status replies. In-game, that means you'll still see the player count on the server list tooltip, but you won't see any player names. In performance and stability news, a change has been made to the JFR profiling in the game. If you trigger this using /JFR or using a startup option, it works like before. But if you start the profiling using an external tool, events for packets will be aggregated instead of triggering one for each packet. In addition to that, a bug has been fixed where the output of /JFR stop didn't have a clickable link. Let's talk about tags. A number of block tags have been added, all of them related to mob spawning. These tags make it possible to control which blocks a certain type of mob spawns on. They are animals spawnable on, axolotls spawnable on, foxes spawnable on, goats spawnable on, mushrooms spawnable on, parrots spawnable on, rabbits spawnable on, wolves spawnable on, and polar bears spawnable on in frozen ocean. That last one doesn't fully control polar bear spawning, as the name implies, it only controls their spawning in frozen ocean. This is because polar bears have different spawn requirements there compared to elsewhere. Now, we're going to get into custom world changes, but first I'd like to take a super quick moment to thank each and every one of you who like the click button. Yeah, that's totally it. Thanks! Now, for custom world changes in this version, let's start with a fix for the vanilla reference data, where even more values of infinity have been removed, making the pack fully valid input. A bug has also been fixed with the new terrain shaper field added in the previous snapshot that didn't actually work when included in a data pack. The amplified boolean field in noise settings now once again has the functionality it did before. This interacts a bit differently with the new terrain, but still causes more tall and shattered terrain to appear. There are also new noises used for large biome type worlds. They have the same names as the normal overworld noises, but with an underscore large suffix. There are two new surface conditions in this version. They are vertical gradient, which has two input fields, true at and below, and false at and above, both of them vertical anchors. In between these two heights, the value is randomized in such a way that the average true count forms a gradient. The other new surface condition type is above preliminary surface. It has no settings and simply returns true if the block position is above the preliminary surface level. In the vanilla data, those new conditions are used to implement the bedrock layers in both overworld and nether, as well as the deep slate transition in the overworld. And with that, the deep slate enabled field has also been removed. And that's it for the technical changes in this snapshot. Thanks for staying all the way to the end, I do appreciate it. And hey, while you're here, maybe you should try out this video too. What is the most efficient mode of transport known to Minecraft? Well, it's teleportation, of course. So today we're gonna build a server-wide teleporter